الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده على من لا نبي بعده ولا أمة بعد أمته ولا كتاب بعد كتابه ولا شريعة بعد شريعته أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد نصركم الله في مواطن كثيرة ويوم حنين إذ أعجبتكم كثرتكم فلم تغن عنكم شيئا وَضَاقَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْعَرْضُ بِمَا رَحُبَتْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَزِيمُ. Respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program, The Rays of Light, where we look at different themes of the Holy Quran. I have recited an ayat in Surah Tawbah. And in this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has referred to the Battle of Hunain. Bear in mind that we are not talking of the historical aspects of the Battle of Hunain, but rather we are looking at what the Quran has said about the battle. However, just for us to understand what the Quran had said, just a very brief background. After the conquest of Makkah, after conquering Makkah, Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is in Makkah. The people of Taif, who are part of a broader tribe known as the Hawazin, and in particular the tribe of Bani Thaqif, who are under the tribe of Hawazin, and the leader Malik bin Auf, he gathered an army and he started making remarks to the point saying that the Quraysh were not renowned warriors. We are renowned warriors. Let Muhammad come and see what real warriorism and what real fighting is. And then he will realize what he has been able to achieve with the Quraysh will not be easily achieved with us. So he gathered his forces. And between Makkah and Taif, he gathered his forces and Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came to know about it. So Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam prepared the army. And Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam left Makkah Mukarramah going towards Taif to counter the threat of Malik bin Auf, the Bani Thaqif tribe, and the broader tribe of Hawazin, many of them who have joined Malik bin Auf and the Bani Thaqif. Now bear in mind that this was the first time in the history of Islam where Muslims outnumbered and were superior in human and other resources over the opponents. And because of this, there was a certain degree of complacency and there was a certain degree of relying upon the numbers which came to the fore and which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Holy Quran has referred to. However, just briefly to recap the historical aspects, Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam goes and Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam passes by a mountain. And when he passes by the valley in that mountain, the tribe of Thaqif, they ambush Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam with such force that momentarily the Sahaba were taken aback and they retreat. And when they retreat, Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is left with a very small band of followers who protect Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu and other Sahaba, they rally around Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and they call the Muslims back and they bring the Muslims back and telling them, do not retreat. The Nabi of Allah is still in your midst. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Ana Nabiyyu la kadhib, Ana ibnu Ibn Abdul Muttalib. I am the Nabi of Allah, there is no falsehood in my claims. And I am the son of Abdul Muttalib, who was well known in this valley. And he was a very prominent, distinguished and influential person. Oh people, rally around me. Sahaba came around Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And after the initial setback, after the initial retreat, when they gather around our beloved Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, eventually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant the Muslims victory in Hunain. And many of them, Malik bin Auf, etc., afterwards, they fled into Taif. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam lays a siege. The incident is a long one. Eventually, many of them become Muslims. Now let us, after this very brief introduction, let us look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says with regard to this and the lessons Allah ta'ala gives. لَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَوَاتِنَ كَثِيرَةً وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنِ. Allah help you on many occasions. And when Allah Ta'ala's help comes, then no one can overcome you. Says Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala in the fourth juz of the Holy Quran in Surah Ali Imran, إِيَنْصُرُكُمُ اللَّهُ فَلَا غَالِبَ لَكُمْ. If Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala helps you, none will be able to overcome you. If Allah Ta'ala forsakes you, who is going to help you thereafter? So Allah Ta'ala says, Allah help you on many occasions, and especially also in Hunayn. إِذْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ. When your numbers pleased you, فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ شَيْهَا. But your numbers did not come to your assistance. It could not help you in gaining victory. Allah Ta'ala wanted to give us this particular great lessons that a Muslim in every walk of his life, collective and individual, he needs to rely upon Almighty Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. He must not look at his resources and take pride. He must take his resources, because Allah has said, tie the camel first and then rely upon Almighty Allah. But after tying the camel, he does not rely upon his asbab and his means. He does not rely upon his wealth to bring his needs and to fulfill his needs. He relies upon Almighty Allah. Allah does not like pride, and Allah does not like conceitedness. Conceitedness is to have a very high regard about yourself. Amongst our ulama, you know, one of our great scholars used to say, جب آدمی اپنے کو برا سمجھنے لگتا ہے تو خدا کی نظر میں گر جاتا ہے. When a person becomes conceited, he falls in the esteem of Allah. Allah does not like conceitedness. Allah does not like pride. And here, the Sahaba were heard to be saying, when we were little, we achieved victory. Now when we are more, we have more resources, we will gain victory. Allah Ta'ala gave them, what a great lesson. Do not look at your resources. Tie your camel, but after tying your camel, rely upon Almighty Allah. Allah does not like conceitedness, and Allah does not like pride. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Allah Ta'ala says, Al-kibri ra'u ridai wal-azmatu azari. Pride is my garment, greatness is my sheet. Whoever claims that for himself, he is like competing with Allah. And whoever competes with Allah, he will be destroyed. So in this beautiful verse, Allah Ta'ala has referred to the incident of Hunayn, but what a great lesson. Let us look at the ayat again, and let us take this lesson. لَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ فِي مَوَاتِنَا كَثِيرًا وَيَوْمَ حُنَيْنَ. Allah help you on many occasions. He help you on the occasion of Hunayn. إِذْ أَعْجَبَتْكُمْ كَثْرَتُكُمْ. When your numbers pleased you. Respected viewers, let us not look at our homes, at our means, and take pride and become happy. Let us use it, no doubt, but then let us turn towards Almighty Allah after adopting our means. Because Allah does not like conceitedness and pride. فَلَمْ تُغْنِ عَنْكُمْ شَيَا. Your numbers pleased you, but did not help you. إِذْ ذَاقَتْ عَلَيْكُمُ الْأَرْضُ بِمَا رَحُبَتْ. The earth became narrow upon you despite its vastness. May Allah Ta'ala give us the tawfiq of, you know, understanding the context of this verse and the great lesson that Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala wishes to impart upon us in this beautiful verse. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.